Tonight, someone you know could be hiding a secret, a part of their life that they never even want you to see.
Yeah, Jessica, this woman approached me and agreed to talk with us only if we would not show her face and if we would disguise her voice when we talked with her on camera. And she showed great courage as she invited us into her home and told her story of how she suffers from compulsive hoarding syndrome. It's tonight's What Matters to You.
It's like, you know, telling somebody that can't stop drinking just to stop because, I don't know how to do it, and I need some help with that.
Jane is not her real name, and she asked us not to show her face on camera.
I'm too embarrassed about the way things are here to bring anybody into my home, and I'm too embarrassed to tell people about why I don't want them to come over to my home, so it really is a pretty isolating thing.
Jane suffers from compulsive hoarding syndrome. She has trouble throwing most anything away.
I worry that I'll need something if I let go of it, and it really scares me for some reason.
She collects stuff, too.
I really like to sew, but as you can see, I have a huge amount of sewing stuff, but no space to sew.
Jane says it was her daughter who first confronted her about her hoarding.
It was my daughter that, like, 10 years ago said something to me. She said, Mom, have you ever noticed how you clean one room, but you put all the stuff that you don't want for that room in another room, and then you have to clean that room?
Health service psychologist Dr. Linda Neal says many times family members are the first people she hears from concerned about someone they love.
And if you have a question or think it's a problem, it probably is.
Dr. Neal says hoarding can be related to other things like obsessive compulsive disorder and depression. She helps her clients through cognitive therapy, and she also believes in support groups.
Just support to say, you know, you're still a lovable, acceptable person, even though you may have a lot of clutter.
Jane is now getting help for her compulsive hoarding, but the road to recovery is slow.
I still think that I'm going to clean that room, even though I've attacked it every weekend for 8 months, and it's still, everything is still there. I just can't seem to let go of things.
And if this sounds like someone you love, we have a couple of resources for you. This Thursday and Friday, Oprah is doing a two-part special, The Secret Lives of Hoarders, including how to get out from all of that clutter. And you can also head to the What Matters to You page of KOCO.com. We have a link to several resources there. A lot of help out there for people, but it is hard, like you heard her say, just to get started.
Yeah.
And to get in there, you do need some help, and I know she's looking for some help as well.
It's kind of seem overwhelming.
Right, exactly.
That's good that she's talking about it.
Yep. You know?